Be still and know that I am God. Now, do you think Tiki is the only one that has a hard time being still? Or Dreema? Or Jessica? Or trying to think of the fidgety as kid in school. Let's see, who would that be? Ariana. Ariana, do you think God wants you to be still, just you, or everybody? Everybody. I'm fidgety. The Lord had to make me a preacher so I could be saved, because if I had to sit in a pew like you and listen to some God talk, I'd never make it. But if I can move around while I talk, I'm okay. But we have a hard time being still in this country. We just hate it. We hate stillness. We hate silence. One older lady told me one time, I leave my TV on all day long, even when I sleep, because it makes me feel better. Makes me feel like I'm not alone. Have you ever heard that? What is it about being still that we don't like? Why do we hate silence so much? In this 21st century, why do we avoid solitude? You may not even know what that word means. Solitude. It means time alone for contemplation or reflection. It's not a word we use very often. And in my message entitled Embrace the Solitude, you may wonder, what in the world am I talking about? Why do we play our TVs, stereos, CD players, iPods, computers, video games so much? Why are we so desperate to avoid any silent time for reflection or meditation? Why do we recoil from the solitude when we should be embracing it? Now, I'm sure whoever read the scripture today read 1 Kings. And you'll notice there that it's kind of interesting. There was an earthquake. And there was a fire, there was a light wind, and the God of fire and wind and earthquake wasn't there in all those, but in the still, small voice you could hear him. Isn't it interesting? Be still, small voice. If you put those two thoughts together, the first text said, be still, and the second one said, still, small voice. Be still, small voice. That's what we say to the Holy Spirit. Be still, small voice. I want to watch that show, and I know you don't want me to, but be still, small voice. I don't have time to read my Bible today. I'm too busy. Be still, small voice. That's what we are hearing. But what God is saying is, be still. Stop. Be quiet. Listen to my still small voice. Do we need to stop and be quiet and listen to his voice? Do we need to embrace solitude? I want you to go with me to Bethany. To Luke 10:38. There's a lady there named Martha. That's where Martha lives. So I want you to go to Bethany with me. Luke 10:38-42. It came to pass as they went that they entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbered about much serving, and came to him and said, Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her therefore that she help me. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things. But one thing is needful, and Mary hath chosen the good part which shall not be taken away from her. Entering Bethany after hiking the steep and dusty trail from Jericho, Jesus and his disciples were very tired. Do you know why they were so tired? Well, Bethany sat upon the eastern shore of the Mount of Olives. It was about a mile and a half east of Jerusalem. And Bethany is at an elevation of about 2,500 feet. That's 3,500 feet higher than Jericho, which was 1,000 feet below sea level. So imagine this. Jesus had to climb 3,500 feet and walk many miles to get from Jericho to Bethany. And him and the apostles were exhausted. Now on this occasion, the group first entered the home of Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha. Martha was apparently the eldest, and thus she welcomed Jesus into their home. Jesus' life had not been easy. The rejection of his message in Jerusalem, Judea, Galilee, and lately Samaria had been very difficult. He had aptly stated that the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head in the previous chapter, Luke 9:58. Our Savior appreciated a quiet home and interested listeners. He longed for human tenderness, courtesy, and affection. Do you ever long for human tenderness, courtesy, and affection? How about in the church today, when you participated in the ordinance of humility? Did you long for tenderness, courtesy, and affection? Somehow we're discourteous. Somehow we don't really listen. Somehow we're not exactly tender, and sometimes we can be pretty unaffectionate.